What's up, everybody? My name's Lucas, and welcome to the start of my Fallout 3 Let's Play. So this is something that I've wanted to do ever since I started this channel, and really my entire life to a certain extent. I have always loved this game. It's probably top three game for me overall, period.
I
And that's
don't want to set the
including hundreds, if not thousands, of games that I've played over
world
my
on
24 years on this earth. So,
I just want to
I am really looking forward to this.
start a flame in your
Hope you guys enjoy this. Like I said, I'm ecstatic to do this. This is such a
In
wonderful
my
game,
heart,
and
I have but
I'm happy to play it for
one
y'all on the channel.
desire.
And I'm sure this
And
song
that
will get me,
one is you.
get the video, claimed, but that's fine.
No other will do.
Such an awesome little
I've
intro and
lost all
cinematic, also.
ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to
You
be
don't
the
really
one you
know what's happening. Like, obviously, there's some destroyed stuff,
love. And with your
old bus or
admission
whatever,
that
or
you
tram.
feel the same,
And you
I'll
get to
have
slow
reached
zoom
the
out, and
goal
you get to see
my
just how bad
dream
everything
of.
is. And then get to see this really awesome dude in power armor. The way I got chills just like the way that he looks back at the camera just as the music's like ramping up, and then it like hits the dramatic note at the end as he's turns to look at the camera. Such a awesome little
War.
musical thing right
War
there.
never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself
Yeah, if you don't
no
know
longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of
mythos
nuclear
behind the Fallout
fire
universe.
and radiation.
Basically, after I think World War II in the 50s, we basically took
But
atomic
it was
power to
not,
its like
as some
logical
had
conclusion,
predicted, the end of the
and like
world.
almost everything was powered by atomic, like our
Instead,
cars were
the
atomic
apocalypse
powered,
was simply the prologue
like
to
just pretty much
another bloody
everything,
chapter of human
and
history.
we never
For
really
man
progressed
had
past that
succeeded in
point.
destroying the world.
So
but war
that's why everything's a little
war never
different. It's just in the
changes
cars they look pretty funky. It's because they were atomic powered, which is kind of cool but also kind of frightening because
in the early days
you're literally driving something that's
thousands were
radioactive.
spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them.
If you emerged.
All except those in Vault 101.
Yeah, there's some, we'll probably get to them
For
later,
on that
but,
fateful day, when fire rained from
the
the
vaults
sky,
are very
the giant
sinister in
steel
their
door of
design.
Vault
They weren't
101
just
slid
to save people
closed
from the fallout
and
like
never
they
reopened.
had some pretty dastardly,
It was here you were born. It is here you
innuendo
will
this
die.
way, I guess.
Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Or do they? Also, this is a really interesting way to start a game. Literal, your little birth. That's how the game starts.
Let's see, are you a boy or a girl?
I'm a boy.
It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son.
Also, if you've never played this game, it's
Beautiful,
totally Liam
healthy
Neeson as your
baby
father,
boy.
voicing your father, which is really cool.
Oh,
I actually
James.
didn't realize that till like years
I
later,
can't.
but it made the game
My
even
son.
cooler. That's freaking Liam Neeson.
Oh, beautiful.
got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
My name is Lucas.
That's a good name, don't you think?
I think so.
Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
Obviously I'm a baby, but this would be kind of creepy if like they did this for you when you were like 5 or 6 to show you what you're going to look like when you get older. But it is cool to, it's a cool idea, I guess. Have hazel eyes. I'm not going to worry about anything else I don't really care about. Let's see. It's honestly pretty similar to my hairstyle. We'll come back to that. I used to have this hairstyle for a lot of my life. Pretty shaggy and long. But I've got it cleaned up a little bit. Yeah, we'll go with this. And... I have a, let's say dirty blonde hair color. Or something like that. Yeah, there we go. Facial hair, I do have some. Probably something like that. See if there's anything else. Yeah, we'll just go with rough beard. There we go. Alright. That's as close to me as I'll probably ever get using the character creator in this game.
Oh, oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
You're just James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest.
Mother!
Bad compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000.
What's up, Madison?
Come on.
Hang on. Yeah, she plays a big part in the game later. That doctor that just pulled us away.
We need a doctor, not a deadly. Fail to meet my expectations and there will be...
Don't look straight into the light,
James, and it's cheery chatter.
May your future be bright. Something in this place will feel just like home. Come on over here, son. Come on.
Dada.
Walk to Daddy. There you go. My goodness. Just a year old and already walking like a pro.
I am kind of a big deal, you know.
I would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo. I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
Yeet. How do I fix the fub? Z? Yep. Yeah, this will actually be my first time actually playing through this game on PC. I have every other single time, all the other dozens of times I've played through this game, it has been on Xbox. So, this should be interesting. Yeah, this is your special book, so this is where you assign your attributes. Let's see. Perception, I've never really found much of a use for, personally. Intelligence is very important. Agility is too. I will bump perception up to 4. There we go. to me. 1 year old, climbing. Climbing up stuff. Oh shit, he found me.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you?
Serves I was doing nothing.
Trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation.
I actually love this Bible verse.
I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that.
It's actually one of my favorites.
All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amata wants to play.
Amata? Don't come with me, Dad. I gotta put the moves on her. I don't want you there.
These experiments
don't be a damn fool. We experiment to prepare. Prepare to survive. Oops, I missed it.
Surprise! Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Hey, look at me, cool girl.
He's growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities.
Yay.
So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Can't wait.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday!
What's up?
We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
You're the best.
You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess.
No idea.
Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak. Issue 14. And with no missing pages.
Aw, shit.
I found this in a box of my father's old things. Believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once.
Hey, I'm 24
well,
and I still read comic books.
I bet he'd let you get back to mingling with your guests.
Hey, don't
we'll talk
trash
later,
me for
okay?
reading comic books, Amata.
Happy birthday.
So, Paul.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously,
I take it
right?
super seriously, man.
Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
You know.
What, are you two best friends now? Hey, Wally, I think Paul's gone soft on him.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amata put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason.
Kind of a big deal.
Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Enjoying yourself?
Yeah. Sure things, her if you're...
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came.
Was that supposed to mean?
Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Fiddlesticks. What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
Thank you. That's very nice.
Who do you mean? Birdface here?
Happy birthday. Oh, shit. Cut the cake. Aw.
How's it going, pal?
I want that piece right there on the far side.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. Don't you talk about my mom, you little punk.
Oh, no.
I'm sorry.
He's hostile.
I am mortified about the cake mishap. Simply mortified.
Butch, what do you think you're doing? Leave him alone.
Enjoying yourself?
You all right, son?
I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about?
He tried to take my present.
Why, that little... I figured it was him that started it. He's been nothing but trouble since the day he was born. You let me handle this and try to stay out of the way.
Sure thing.
All right, Butch.
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party.
I know, the nerve.
What a jerk. God, he really is a butthead.
He really is.
Oh well, you can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
All right, Butch.
Either
Daddy,
butt, bro.
I told you not to
have
all of
I've had
one.
It with you, Butch. Your mother is going to hear about this.
About the cake.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything?
Yep.
As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
Thank you.
Let's go ahead and put that baby on. Let's go ahead and read that and eat our sweet roll.
Always enjoy my little speech.
For now, just remember,
besides,
I'm keeping my eye on you.
Can use a reminder that
look at my little hat.
All fun and games.
A little big on me, but it's fine.
Just because I came to your party doesn't mean I have to talk to you.
Enjoying yourself?
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Could be worse. My name could be Wally.
So, what do you think we should call our name? It's gotta be totally
I know you were
killer.
Busy with the water purifier.
Hey, how about the vault wall?
Everything's fine,
get
I
it?
Hope.
Jonas?
Who wants to go
oh,
around
sure,
all day being called
me and Andy
got
all set down here.
Again last
night.
You really are as
thanks to my eyes.
Send him right down.
Enjoying yourself?
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Enjoying yourself?
Right. Like that?
I'm glad you could make it.
I don't know. Maybe.
Happy birthday, dearie.
Beatrice.
My goodness. I hope I didn't miss the party.
Kinda did.
They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you. A great big grown-up 10-year-old. With your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem. Just for you.
Oh, I shouldn't
I
have.
Hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
Shut up.
All right, let's look at this birthday poem. Gray walls, impenetrable steel, suffocation, condemnation, little hands groping in subterranean uncertainty. Mommy, Daddy, am I dead? Nay, nay. Reborn into purifying fluorescence. A face emerges, strong and male, father to me, father to all. Overseeing our lives, our eternities. Harshness of discipline, harshness of love, obedience my savior. Larva to pupa, pupa to worker, buzz buzz, one with the steel honeycomb, 10 lies within the 101. Significant at last, till grace seeps from walls to hair to soul, then eternal slumber, the sweet sleep of incineration. Alright, thank you for that. That was enlightening.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level.
Bitch up 10.
You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Bet.
Are you ready for your surprise?
Sure.
The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try?
Kids, it's great.
We sure can't, unless we want the overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on.
Oh, shit. Bam. Oh, okay. You actually can shoot them and they get pissed.
Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun?
Yes, is there, they want you to use vets?
Yes.
Get wrecked.
Good work. That's one less rad roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
Smile.
Cheese.
Boys and girls have different parts.
It's her part anyway, so I'm the overseer's daughter, so what? That like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your GOAT exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take.
But Dad.
The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep.
Can't promise.
You know what the overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all Vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar? Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now.
Them's
so
the
this
rules.
Year, you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck.
Be swiping your bobblehead. Smart man knows a bandage only hides his wounds. See what you got here. Freddy, Speedy S is getting worse. Most days he can't even get out of bed. When he does manage to function, Freddy hides his insecurities and low self-esteem behind a bully's mask. Vault Tech medical protocols dictate the prescription of anti-anxiety medication. Medication Vault depressive syndrome is involved. But I really want to string the kid out on chlorpromazine for the rest of his life. Stanley continues to suffer from severe and chronic head pain. I've been feeding him aspirin like it's candy, but I'm reticent to give him anything stronger. He blames the lighting in his quarters, and though eye strain is certainly compounding the problem, headaches are actually a symptom of overwork and lack of sleep. Knowing Stanley and the schedule the overseer has him on, the problem isn't likely to get better anytime soon, so it's aspirin indefinitely. Amada? Once again, the overseer has insisted on being in the room for Amada's examination, throwing any inkling of doctor-patient confidentiality right out the window. I know he doesn't trust me, he never has, but I honestly believe the reason he attends his daughter's medical appointments is because he doesn't trust her. That's as ridiculous as it is sad. Amada's a great girl, the chances for doing something stupid, pregnancy, syphilis, whatever, is so unlikely it's not even worth mentioning. Experiments. The cells are still replicating normally, no mutation, thank God. If whatever's out there could penetrate this vault, I can't even begin to imagine what the overseer would do. After borrowing a few more water chips and rerouting some of the power here in the clinic, I've finally been able to affect the latest sample. It's not much, but considering what I have to work with it, definite step in the right direction. This new experiment is also monumental for another reason. It's the first time Jonas has assisted me. He suspected forever, I know, so I guess it was inevitable. And his help has been invaluable. I just hope he knows what he's gotten himself into. Yeah, so kind of... I guess I won't spoil it yet. That's kind of like a... Those experiments are kind of a,
Good morning. Hey, 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 sport. It's
been a
while
word?
Since you stopped in here to see us. It's the big goat way, day today, right?
What am I trying to say? Foreshadowing, there we go.
You better stay away. I don't want you to catch what I've got.
Sorry about that, buddy.
What are you gonna do, Butch? Go run and tell your daddy.
Get away from me!
You think you're special because you...
Stupid tunnel snakes! Immature assholes, if you ask me!
Tunnel snakes rule.
Why won't they leave me alone? It's not my fault my father's the overseer. I don't care about their stupid gang. Can you talk to them? Maybe Butch will listen to you. Please?
Sure thing.
Thanks. You've always been a good friend. Try talking to Butch. They'll all do whatever he says.
Gotcha. Daddy is the over... Yeah? What do you want?
You know.
Damn right. And you'll stay out of our way if you know what's good for you.
Bitch.
No one messes with the tunnel snakes. Especially not this stuck-up little daddy's girl. Like I'm gonna listen to a little shrimp like you. Get lost, Poindexter.
Alright.
And who are you? Her boyfriend? Ha! Keep talking like that, boy. And we'll send you back to your daddy with a few broken bones for him to fix.
Let's do it.
You've gotta be kidding me.
Butch, stop it! Okay. Leave him alone!
Tough guy, huh?
Yeah!
Give him another one!
Please! Stop fighting!
Slow motion.
Hey, Susie,
hit him again!
Please,
maybe this
stop
time
fighting!
Stick.
Our heater's on the fridge.
Hit him again! You're kidding.
This isn't solving anything!
Didn't you post parts for it last week?
Yeah, sure did.
This isn't solving anything!
Come on, tunnel snakes. This little bitch isn't worth our time.
Again soon for
whatever you're doing that somewhere
else. You're the boss, snakes. Tunnel snakes rule.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
I got a crush on you, Amada.
Let's go.
Sure thing. How about we head down to the diner after class?
That's great. Bothering you. Good luck on the goat.
You well, too.
I can run a few more tests if you like.
Yes, I think I'd like that. Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. Listen, I like your dad. I might even like you if I wasn't your teacher. So here's what I'm going to do. If you want to skip the test, just tell me how you want it to come out, and I'll take care of it for you. Good for you.
Yeah, I'll take the test because the test is actually
fine. As soon as everyone's found a seat, we'll
humorous.
Get started.
Will it take long? I'm also going to save here. Because there's a chance that sometimes when you sit down at these chairs, the game kind of glitches out and won't start.
Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started.
Let's do it.
Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response?
Up your stew, buddy.
Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do?
Maybe amputate it?
Question three.
I worked for Herschel in The Walking
Discover
Dead.
A young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question four.
I don't want to punish the kid too hard.
Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer?
I like pitching. I pitched in high school.
Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another Vault resident. What do you do?
Throwing tea in Granny's face.
Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed?
Um, I will use a bobby pin.
Question 7. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment?
Sure, remove it, I guess.
Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1.
Ooh.
You want it. What's the best way to obtain it?
I'm stealing that shit.
Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father.
I wouldn't actually steal it in real life. I'm just.
When no one is looking, and.
Also, this one is fucked up. Like, placing high blood pressure pills with sugar pills, like. That's.
Question 10.
That's dangerous.
Who is indisputably the most important person involved 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives.
Ah, crap, I knew I should have studied for this question. The Overseer?
Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Yes?
Wow. Wow. It says here you're going to be the Vault's marriage counselor. Almost makes me want to get married, just to be able to avail myself of your services. Closer to reality than you might think. Listen, I was just as obnoxious at your age. I didn't take the goat seriously, and look where I ended up. Just between you and me. The whole test is a joke. If you don't like the results, I can make your goat come out any way you want. Just let me know.
Okay. I'm good with speech. I like speech. Sneak and lockpick. There we go. Denzo.
I'll see you tomorrow, bright and early.
Anything is possible, even an A.
That is the promise.
19 years old.
Selfish and insubordinate.
Wake up! Come on, wake up!
What? 5 more minutes.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here! Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you!
What do you mean he's gone?
He's left the vault! I don't know how, but he's gone, and my father, he's kind of gone crazy. I thought so too, but... it's true. He's gone, and Jonas is dead, and now they're looking for you.
Those bastards.
I don't know! Some of my father's men? Look, that doesn't matter right now.
Kinda
you
does.
Need to worry about getting out of here alive. Revenge will have to wait. That's exactly what I had in mind. Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it.
Gotcha.
Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case.
Alright.
Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck!
Thanks, Mata.
I'll meet you at the vault door if I can.
Alright, I think that is a solid place to end this first part. Like I said, super excited to get out of the vault, get into the actual real game. And yeah, if you made this far in the video, I really appreciate you watching, and I will see you all in the next one. See ya.